I welcome you all to the second lecture of this welding process. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the different types of welding process, that is the solid state welding process and its types, and the different welding joints. So now we have discussed what is solid state welding process. In solid state welding process, we don't require the elevated temperature near melting point, and we also don't use the filler material in solid state welding. Now these are the types of different solid state welding. So first type is diffusion welding. In diffusion welding, we keep two joining material together at high pressure and elevated temperature. So in this, the joining process is done with the help of solid state diffusion. And diffusion means when we keep two material together at some pressure, the atomic diffusion takes place, and due to this atomic diffusion between the two parts, the bond formation happens. And since the formation of this bond, the joining process is done. So this is what diffusion welding is. Now the second welding type is the friction welding, or we can say stir welding. So when we provide relative motion between the two surfaces, the heat increases and the temperature also increases between the surfaces, and plastic deformation occurs. And due to this, the joining process is done in friction welding process. Now the same way in ultrasonic welding process, we provide moderate pressure in between the surface, and oscillating motion at ultrasonic frequencies is used in direction parallel to the contacting surface, and due to this the temperature increases and joining process is done. Now these are the joints that we usually use in welding operations. So you have performed some experiments in our workshop over this butt joint. And this is the corner joint, lap joint, T joint, S joint. So these are the joints that usually we use in welding operations. Now, when we perform welding operations, the temperature increases at the junction of two material, and different zone also form between the junction. So we need to know that what are those zones and what are the properties of those zones, and how the property of material get changed after performing welding operation. So this is the schematic diagram. The first central zone is known as the fusion zone, where the pure melting occurs. Now the weld interface differentiates the fusion zone with the heat affected zone, and this is the heat affected zone, and the former one is the unaffected base metal zone. And if we talk about the granular form of this different zone, it looks like this. And the first one, that is a fusion zone, having columnar grains in fusion zone. So we need to understand what is a fusion zone. So fusion zone basically consists the mixture of filler metal and base metal, and that have completely melted. So at high degree homogeneity is found in this region, because the pure melting is occurring in this region. So when the solidification starts, due to steep gradient of the temperature, because the solidification starts in the generally in at the room temperature, and the difference between the melting temperature and room temperature is very high. So the grain reforms itself in a particular direction, and you can say the direction is the perpendicular to the surface of joining. So this kind of arrangement is basically is called epitaxial grain growth, and this is epitaxial means grain growth occurs in a certain manner, or you can say a certain defined manner. It is not random. So this kind of grain growth is called epitaxial grain growth. And now this columnar grain occurs due to the steep temperature difference. So if we see this image with the help of any microscope, we will see this kind of grains structure in fusion zone. And now if you talk about the heat affected zone, this is the second region after this fusion zone, but in between comes the weld interface. So what is this weld interface? So weld interface is nothing, it is a narrow boundary that separates the fusion zone from the heat affected zone. Fusion zone where the complete melting is happening, and the heat affected zone is different, where melting is not happening. So first of all, we need to know that weld interface is nothing but a narrow region which differentiates fusion zone from the heat affected zone. This zone consists of thin band of base metal, and this is partially melted due to heat interaction from the fusion zone. And now the heat affected zone. This zone is between the weld interface and the base material. What is base material? This is the base material where no effect is happening here. There is no effect of this temperature. This is the base material. And now the heat affected zone is between the weld interface and base material. This experiences temperature below melting point. So melting is not happening in the heat affected zone, but the temperature is sufficient to change the microstructure and properties of the material. So what happened when we performed the welding operation, the properties of this heat affected zone get changed, and the arrangement of grains also changes. And this is the most weakest damaged part of the welding welded component. So if anything happened after welding, if any failure occurs in welding operation, this usually happens in this heat affected zone region. So we try to minimize this heat affected zone to reduce the failure after the welding operation. What is the base material now? The base material is unaffected because of the heat regeneration and preserve the initial microstructure. What happened when we start welding operation? So the material which is far away from this region never get experience any kind of temperature, a high temperature. So the grains is usually found in the same way that it was before. So this is called the unaffected region. The waste material is unaffected from this elevated temperature. So these were the effect of temperature and welding operation over the material. Now what is the heat energy in fusion welding? So basically in fusion welding we melt the filler material as well as the base material. So first of all we need two kind of heat interaction here. The first kind of heat interaction that will come into picture to elevate the temperature of the solid metal to the melting point. And again after that the material will require the phase change, and the phase change happen when we provide the latent heat. So you can read this sentence here: heat energy required to change the temperature of solid metal to its melting point, and that depends on the volumetric specificity, right? Now the melting point of material, we need to know what is the melting point of the material. Now we also need to know what is the latent heat of the material. Heat required to change the solid state to liquid phase, that depends on the heat of fusion of the material. Okay, now after combining all these aspects, we come to know about this single formula, that is the melting heat energy should be equal to K times Tm2. So here K is a constant that is calculated experimentally, and Tm is the melting point of the metal. So this is how we can calculate the heat energy interaction in fusion welding. Now in next lecture we will start the arc welding, and what are the basic features of arc welding and where we use arc welding. Okay, thank you.